السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله، الحمد لله، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. First of all, I would like to invite our president of KSA to the stage, and secretary, as well as Brother Hassan Bawaka. And also Brother Hasanuddin, I would like to invite him to the stage. Respected speaker, Brother Zaid Patel, my dear brothers and my dear students, I welcome you all to this afternoon's guest lecture on the subject, How to Be a Bright Student. Before we move on to the lecture, first I invite our madrasa student, Brother Master Zaid, to come to the stage and recite us verse from the glorious Quran with the meaning and interpretation of it. Later on, I also invite, after the qiraat, I invite Brother M.H. Hamid to introduce our speaker to the audience. Assalamu alaikum.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. يا بني إنها إن تك مثقال حبة من خردل فتكون في صخرة أو في السماوات أو في الأرض يأتي بها الله، إن الله لطيف خبير. يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف وانهى عن المنكر واصبر على ما أصابك، إن ذلك من عزم الأمور. ولا تصعر خدك للناس ولا تمشي في الأرض مرحا، إن الله لا يحب كل مختال فخور. وقصد في مشيك واغضض عن صوتك، إن أنكر الأصوات لصوت حمير. And Luqman alayhi wassalatu wassalam said, O my son, that a wrong should be the weight of mustard seed and should be within a rock or anywhere in the heavens or in the earth. Allah will bring it forth. Indeed, Allah is subtile and aware. O my son, establish prayer, enjoin what is right, forbid what is wrong, and to be patient over what befalls you. Indeed, all that is of matters requiring resolve. And do not turn your cheek in contempt towards people, and do not walk through the earth exultantly. Indeed, Allah does not like everyone self-willed and boastful. And be moderate in your pace and lower your voice. Indeed, the most disagreeable of sound is the voice of donkeys. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Now I invite Brother Zaid Patel onto the stage, and also Brother M.H. Hamid, to introduce Brother Zaid Patel to our audience.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inna alhamdulillah, nahmaduhu wa nasta'inuhu. Wassalatu wassalam nabiyyina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. Dear brothers, already it is now 1:15, 1:20. We don't have much time. We have to wind up the program before 2 o'clock. I'll not be going to the big introduction. Most of you are aware of his visit to Saudi, and he has conducted almost 30 days of continuous marathon programs throughout Saudi Arabia. This is his last program. As for this visit, he will be flying back to India, inshallah, tonight. We are all fortunate to have Brother Zaid Patel with us, and he is the president of International Islamic Center, Mumbai, which has 3 Dawah centers, which I am always, you know, I introduce in my. I am fortunate, in fact, most of his speeches, I only did the introduction. I have been requesting others to do this honor, because it is definitely my, you can say, honor to introduce such a great personality. MashaAllah, he is so humble and so good. He is expert in Dawah work, and he has got so much of information with him, and he is sharing it with the people. And I request all of you to take his notes, which he has made it in such a beautiful way, in points, which you can use it to Dawah all the time. And today he has taken a special subject. This is specially for students above 10 years. And all the parents, they want their children to be bright, study well, do well in personal, and also all other activities. With this in mind, we have chosen this subject. We invited the parents also, not mother, but fathers, and also some of the elders, or you know, more than 10 years of age, all of them we have invited, so that they will know exactly what they have to do to make their children as bright as possible. So inshallah, today you will get more information on this subject. And without going further introduction, I would like to, you know, maybe I'll just say that he's embarking on a television channel. It's a huge venture, and I say it's never happened in the history for people who wants to follow Quran and Sunnah as per the proof available. And plus his Nasiha TV motto itself is har baat dalil ke saath, that means with the proof only it will be presented to you. MashaAllah, today presenting the Islam in the correct way, it's the most important plus most difficult thing. If you don't do that one, all the wrong things which you will see now, it is because of that only. This responsibility is on all of us. Inshallah, with his participation in the television program, it will definitely help all our Muslims throughout the world. We pray that he will be successful, inshallah, in this venture. And whatever we can do to make sure that it is successful, let us try to do it also. Without further delay, I request Brother Zaid Patel Sahab to come and start his lecture. Jazakallahu khair wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah wa salatu wa salam ala rasulillah wa ala ahlihi wa sahabihi ajmain amma ba'd. Qala ta'ala fi kalamihi al-majid, wa ma khalaqtu al-jinna wal insa illa liya'budun. Rabb ishrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa ahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Respected organizers, our elders, and my dear brothers, our subject today is very important for every student. And even though elders are present today, my main talk is specially for the youngsters, and I also, inshallah, all those young children who I hope will see this video and try to become bright students in the light of the Quran and the Sunnah. Our subject is how to be a bright student. How to be a bright student. First is, who is a bright student? If we know who is a bright student, we can try to be a bright student. So first, we will have to define who is a bright student. is he a student who has all light coming out of him? So he's really bright, we can say. Let's say, come on, let me have the young children. You can tell me, who is a bright student? Feel free, even though there are some elders watching, but no problem. We all can be free and you can speak your heart out. Even if someone gives a wrong answer, it's not a problem, inshallah. And if you give a right answer, then I have heard some information that there is something in store for those people who give good answers, inshallah. Okay, so my young brothers, who can tell who's a bright student? Come on, say something. Otherwise, I'll have to pass the question to elders. Yes. Student who gets good marks, this is one answer. Okay, someone else? Yes, bacha. Who listen to their elders, he's a bright student, okay. Who else?
As a bright personality.
Bright personality, mashallah. All three added different dimensions to the answer, mashallah, very good. Who else is a bright student? People like him. Most of the people like him. Well, actually, people may like a film star also. Is he a bright person? No. So, not necessarily everyone has to like, but okay, what I take from you is that he's a person who has good akhlaq and character, and due to which people connect better with him. Yes. What else? Sorry?
Hardworking.
Okay. So, my dear children, you know what? Who is a bright student? Some people say he's the person who gets good marks. We say, let's not connect brightness to marks. Let's connect brightness to learning. Let's connect brightness to having awareness and being the right person in the world. As we go ahead, inshallah, we will be adding more and more points about who is a bright student. Basically, I want to share with you 7 points today. And I really believe that if a student acts on these 7 points, he will be incredibly successful, inshallah, in both dunya and akhirah. That is the goal. That is true brightness. See, if a person is very good, he gets good marks in the dunya, and he goes to Jahannam, so is he really bright or was he dull? He was really dull to not be able to make it to Jannah. Similarly, there's a person who is good for the akhirah, but he doesn't do right things for the dunya, because Islam has also taught us how to lead our lives in the dunya, how to be good and successful in the dunya. So let's start without more of an introduction. Come on, we start the first point. The first point is the bright student has to know what is the purpose of his life. What is the purpose of his life? Meaning, why is he living? What is the purpose of coming in this world? See, I'll give you an example. Why is this mic here? This mic is here for what? For taking my voice across. Why is this table here? It's for the mic generally, it's a podium. What is this mobile here for? You can see there's something on recording. It's for recording, isn't it? Somebody's trying to record the lecture. What are these books here for? For knowledge? Ah, this is the gift, inshallah. We find that everything has a purpose. Everything has a purpose. This light is here for a purpose. This AC is here for a purpose. This window is here for a purpose. This wall is here for a purpose. This floor is here for a purpose. Then what are we here for? Even we have a purpose. Everything in this world which is sensible. See, only a person who is not sensible will do things without purpose. Otherwise, everything has a purpose, has a reason. And the reason why we human beings are in this world, we need to know. My dear children, I'll want to ask you a question. Can I ask, whom should I ask? You should be comfortable. Can I ask you some questions? Huh? Okay, sit. Show me your hand. Raise your hand. You can see this hand? Did you make this hand? Did you make these fingers? Who made? Allah Rabbul Alameen made. We didn't make these fingers. We didn't make our eyes. We didn't make our ears. Allah Rabbul Alameen made. And Allah Rabbul Alameen, Jazakallah Khair, made. And not only that, we didn't even ask for it. Did we ask Allah, "Oh Allah, I'm going in the world, I need two hands. I need each hand with five fingers." And fingers are also not just straight. If the fingers would have been straight, is a problem. These are fingers with which we can hold, with which we can do so many things. So you must have seen the crane which picks up weights. They made the crane after seeing what? After seeing the hand. They made the aeroplane after seeing what? The birds flying. They made what after seeing the fishes? Ships, boats, submarines. Now we see man makes things after seeing a previous model. Allah Rabbul Alameen made the hand after seeing the crane? No, Allah is the one who made the hand without a previous model. Now, my dear children, what's very important for all of us, that we should know why we have all these blessings from Allah. We should know the purpose of all of these things. Allah Rabbul Alameen gave us everything and gave us everything in the right place. See, He gave us everything in the right place. Imagine if the legs would be up and the hands would be down. Imagine how would things be if our eyes would be behind. The mouth is in the front and the eyes are behind. Allah Rabbul Alameen gave us everything what we needed. And everything in the perfect manner. See, do you know that if there was no gravity, then we would all be flying. And how it happens in space? Now you want to drink water? So water, if you leave it open, it will start flying. But Allah Rabbul Alameen gave us gravity. And if gravity would have been more, if the gravity, the force of gravity would have been more than what it is, then we wouldn't be able to even lift our leg. Our leg would have been stuck on the ground because there's so much gravity, it's pulling the leg down, you cannot lift your leg. Human being doesn't, you need a powerful machine to pull your leg up. But Allah Rabbul Alameen gave us everything in perfect order. How we needed it, Allah Rabbul Alameen gave it. So Allah says in the Quran in Surah Nahl, Surah 16, verse 18, وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِيمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you were to count the favor of Allah, you cannot even number it. How many favors of Allah are there? We cannot count, we cannot even number. Cannot even number them. Number them means? What is the meaning, we can't number them? Meaning what? We can't give them a figure. Okay, there are 10 favors of Allah. There are 20 favors. There are 100 favors. There are 1,000 favors. There are 1 million favors, 1 billion favors. We cannot number them. My question to you, why we cannot number? Why we cannot number? Because they are so many. So we have big numbers. Millions, billions, trillions. We can count. We have big computers who can count lots of numbers. Why we can't number? There's so many we don't even know. Jazakallah, perfect answer. What we know we can count. What we don't know how we'll count. What we know we can count. What we don't know how we'll count. Like for example, you know the ozone layer. What does the ozone layer do? From the bad rays of the sun, it protects us. Now the ozone layer started depleting. And that is when people came to know there was an ozone layer. Something starts going. See, you know what? We all are sitting here, we all are using everything. We don't know the value. You ask someone who doesn't have eyes, he knows the value of eyes. You ask someone who is a kidney patient. Kidney patients have to be on what, which machine? Dialysis machine. Now the kidney patient who's on dialysis machine, he knows the value of a kidney. He knows the value of a kidney. You ask a person who is handicapped, he knows the value of legs. Something a person starts losing, that's when they realize, kitni badi ne'mat hai. What a big blessing it was. So my children, who's sensible? Sensible is the person, pay attention. Sensible is the person who realizes the value of something before it goes. Before it goes. You know, you've seen the dialysis machine. Who's seen the dialysis machine? Who's seen? None of you have seen? May Allah keep you protected always from all of these things. Who has seen the dialysis machine? Such a big machine. Such a big machine. Allah Rabbul Alameen has given us a small dialysis machine inside. And we are walking and running with it. Even with the dialysis machine, the patient cannot last for more than a few years, maximum. Because the kidney does so many other things also. Allah Rabbul Alameen has given us such a beautiful system. See, do you know, if we were to see, scientists tell us that we have such an intricate system of veins in our body that if we were to remove every single vein and connect every vein with the second vein, there are so many veins, how many kilometers? They say it can go round the earth and come back in one single person. So many veins are there, blood vessels. Huh? Allah Rabbul Alameen is the creator. It's perfect architecture. Now so many people, they don't think, they only live. So the bright student is the one who realizes, why am I living? And do you know why we are living? Why are we living? We are living to worship Allah. Allah Rabbul Alameen says in the Quran in Surah Zariyat, Surah 51 verse 56. Who can tell the verse? Surah Zariyat, Surah 51 verse 56. You can tell, mashallah, tell. No, you missed it. It's about? Yes, yes. I think one person can take responsibility of the prizes. Huh? And I can tell, inshallah, ke, please give there. So that vaan se directly pahunch jayega. We'll save some time. Yes, yes. Alhamdulillah, since you tried, we will give you. Yes, my bachcha. Tell. Wama khalaqtul? Loud, mashallah. Speak for Islam. Huh? All of us. Mashallah. What does it say? What is the translation? Who can tell? You'll get the prize, mashallah. Huh? Hassan bhai is in charge of the prizes. Okay. And listen, to reduce the disturbance, let us put the prizes a little behind so that it'll go faster. Yes, you will tell? Huh? No, sorry, you got a chance, na? I think I should give someone else a chance. Yeah. Allah created jinns and men so that we may worship Him. Illa liyabudun. Allah says, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I have created jinns and men only so that they may worship me. Only so that we worship Allah Rabbul Alameen. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he explained this verse, إِلَّا لِيُوَحِدُونَ. So that we worship Allah alone. So my dear children, the purpose of our life is to realize our Creator and to dedicate all our acts of worship for Allah Ta'ala. Do you know what happens? When we know why we are living, you can be really bright for the dunya and for the akhirah. If you don't know why you are living, if you don't know what's happening in the world, so life has ups and life has downs. There are sometimes we succeed, there are also times we fail. Now when a person fails, he should not fail in the real sense. If he goes up, he should not become proud. If he goes down, he should not become depressed. And that can happen when you know where we are going. Up and down is not the purpose of our life. Some people say, my purpose of my life is to go up. Now life, everyone won't go up. Some people will go top, some people will be middle, some people will be below that. But if we know where we are going, if you reach there, you are successful. That's real brightness. So my children, don't be lost with all the crowds of people in the world who don't know why they're living. They don't know. You know, so many people in our current schools, in colleges, they say, no purpose in our life. They say, there's no purpose. There's no purpose, this is falsehood. This is fooling yourself. This is like closing the eyes to the reality. Like for example, you see a lion coming. If you see a lion coming, what you'll do?
We'll run.
You'll run? Okay, what you'll do? Any other answer? Anything else? What will you do? Right. If you see a lion, huh? Escape. Sorry?
Try to hide.
Mashallah. Good, very intelligent. Yes, what will you do? Ask Allah for help and do something also other than that? Huh? Asking Allah for help, yes. But we have to also do other things. Trust in Allah and tie your camel, mashallah. Yes, bacha, tell. What you'll do? Dua, yes. What else? While doing dua, you have to do something else also? Yes, we have to do something else. Huh? Yeah, dua and something else. Sitting and lion is coming, Allah help me. But Allah has also told you to tie your camel. That means you run now. Or do other things, yes. MashaAllah. You know, once I asked this question in one class, and one child gave me a very courageous answer. He said, I will take a stick. Anyway, coming back here, everyone will do something at least, isn't it? Will someone sit over there and just close your eyes? If you close your eyes, you can't see the lion. If you close your eyes, you can't see the lion. What do you think? Is this a good idea? Good idea or bad idea? Good idea, bad idea? And so many people are doing just that. So many people in the world, they don't want to think what is the purpose of their life. They don't want to ponder about this. So my children, you don't do like this. Full life. From now till we are living, you should know what are you doing in this world. What are we doing? This life is an exam. We will take the favors of Allah, and if we don't think, then such a person is very dull. He is so dull that a person who doesn't realize the purpose of his life, he deserves to go to the fire of hell. If he takes all the favors from Allah, but doesn't want to thank Allah. Luqman is telling his son, Ya Bunayya, O my son. Verse number 13 of Surah Luqman. Surah 31, verse 13. La tushrik billah. Don't associate anyone with Allah. Don't join any partners with Allah. Inna shirka la zulmun azim. Because shirk, associating, joining partners with Allah, is the biggest zulm, is the biggest injustice. So now some people, they say that someone else also controls the universe other than Allah. Shirk. Some people say there is someone else who is like Allah. Shirk. Some people say we have to dedicate some acts of worship for other than Allah. This is also shirk. Some people say that we worship our man-made systems. Man-made systems we worship. This is also becoming shirk in different ways. So my children, we also need to know that what is the purpose of our life. Will you remember? The purpose of our life is, we are living in this world to worship Allah Rabbul Alameen. Illa liyabudun. For no other reason but to worship Allah Ta'ala. This is the purpose. Now Islam is not telling us to go in the jungle. Islam is telling us, you do what you're doing. You're a student, be a good student. You're a businessman, be a good businessman. You're working somewhere, work properly. But all for what? For Allah. Goodness for Allah. Avoid bad things for whom? For whom? Avoid the wrong things. For whose sake? For Allah's sake. Yes, my children? Started, number one. Number two, now first after realizing what is the purpose of our life. Why are we living? To worship Allah Ta'ala. Second thing, my children, I want to encourage you that seeking knowledge is compulsory for ala kulli Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith recorded by Imam Ibn Abdul Barr in his book Jami Bayan al-Ilm, authenticated in Sahih al-Jami, talabul ilmi faridatun ala kulli Muslim. Seeking knowledge is compulsory for every single Muslim. My question to you, Hassan bhai is ready. Question to you, seeking knowledge, which knowledge? Science, maths, geography, history, yes. To read Quran, okay, mashallah, since you tried, you will get, mashallah. I like people who are courageous to speak, yes, for Islam. Sorry? Knowledge of the Quran, okay, that is already said, okay? Yes, my children? Knowledge of Islam, yes, you will also get, mashallah. So we can keep the stock behind. So we can have one person from Hassan bhai behind. Who can be behind? Inshallah, kindly arrange. Yes, yes, my bacha. Sorry? Translation of the Quran, seeking knowledge about Islam. That's general, mashallah, you will also get, all four will get. Yes, my child. Sorry? Of a salah, we are talking of knowledge. Action will come little later. We are talking. Okay? Tell me more. Yes?
Knowledge of Deen and Dunya.
Very good answer. He will get a little bigger prize. This child will get a little bigger prize. Why? Because he has given a very important perspective. See my children, there is a dua of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned in Sunan Ibn Majah. Allahumma inni as'aluka ilman nafiya. Oh Allah, I seek from you beneficial knowledge. What is the meaning of beneficial? Beneficial means what? Beneficial knowledge. What does it mean? Huh? Something which is? No. Meaning what? Benefit, mashallah. Beneficial knowledge. Acha, tell me, which knowledge is the most beneficial knowledge? Which is the most beneficial knowledge? Yes. Islamic knowledge is the most beneficial knowledge. Why? Because this knowledge tells us who is our creator. It tells us why are we living. It tells us about success of the akhirah. Isn't it? Real success is? Allah says in the Quran, وَمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. The life of this world is nothing but goods and chattels of deception. And Allah says, وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى. Akhirah is khair. Akhirah is lasting. Akhirah is lasting. Lasting meaning what? It doesn't disappear. Dunya, if a person is the richest man in the world, what will he take with him in his grave? Can you take your car in the grave?
No.
Huh? Your favorite mobile?
No.
Nothing. Everything we leave behind. So dunya is not lasting, but akhirah is lasting. So the most important knowledge is the knowledge of Islam. But I'm asking a question now. For this question, there's a double prize, a little bigger prize than me. Huh? Big and small also you have to remember, inshallah. So bigger prize for this question. The question is, my children, tell me, the most beneficial knowledge is the knowledge of Islam, because it takes us to the success of the akhirah. Now if someone says that part of this dua, which dua? Allahumma inni asaluka ilman nafiya. Oh Allah, I seek from you beneficial knowledge. If someone says part of this dua is also knowledge of geography, knowledge of chemistry, knowledge of computers, knowledge of medicine, knowledge of engineering, knowledge of management, even this is a part of this dua, then is this right or wrong? Who says it's right? Okay, raise your hand. Okay, raise properly. It's right? Huh? Who says it? Why is it right? See, akhirah is khair, na? Or management is khair. What is khair? Yeah, then, how is this part of this dua? Who will answer? 1 minute. Who will answer? One hand, two hands. No, your hand is not up. You tell. Yes.
You have to be successful in deen and dunya. So that's why the other things...
Who can tell the question? What is the question?
No.
Sometimes what happens when I ask the answer, so people say, what is the question? Before that, they don't ask. If you don't listen to anything, you should ask before only, okay? What's the question? Yes. Is this part of beneficial knowledge? Ilman nafiya. Beneficial knowledge is history, geography, chemistry, medicine, management, engineering. Also part of ilman nafiya. So what is, you think it's part of ilman nafiya?
No.
No? Okay. Who says it's part of ilman nafiya? Not even a single one of you. Come on, now the prize is ready for you. Yes, tell. How? What is better, dunya or akhirah? Akhirah, then how is this ilman nafiya? But why?
Because like,
what is success?
Success is to become to have a good life.
You will get a small prize because you tried, mashallah. But still hitting the hammer on the on the nail. So I want someone who can just hit the hammer straight on the nail. Yes. Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. Where is it given? Okay, mashallah, you're trying. Very good, mashallah. You'll also get a small prize. Who's making note of this? Okay, mashallah, he's ready now with it. Very good. I like it. Huh? You will decide whether small or big. I'll tell you when it is big. Huh? Yes. Mashallah. Come here, bacha. Come here. I think I should congratulate. Mashallah. Rabbana atina. It's a big prize for him. Fi dunya hasana. Wa fil akhirati hasana. Oh our Lord, give us good of this world and good of the akhirah. So now, ilman nafiya, beneficial knowledge. So isn't it beneficial that you save somebody's life? Isn't it beneficial that you can make a good building? Isn't it beneficial that you can do your work on computer? It is beneficial. But what is the most beneficial knowledge? Most beneficial is akhirah. Now my children, do you know, Islam is the religion which makes people think, which makes people use their brains, which makes people create scientists. Islam is that religion. If you see in the Quran, 24 places Allah says, أَفَلَا تَعْقِلُونَ. Will you not use your aql? Will you not use your aql? Why has Allah given you aql? For using it. Then Allah says, أَفَلَا تُبْصِرُونَ. Will you not see? Will you not see means? Will you not see means? See meaning what? Realize, mashallah, prize. Very good. See meaning what? See, Allah Ta'ala is saying, will you not see? It doesn't mean I'm seeing. It means you're seeing, but you're still not seeing. There are so many people who see, but still don't see. The point is realization. Then Allah says, أَفَلَا تَتَفَكَّرُونَ. Will you not ponder? Will you not ponder? Think. So Allah wants us to think. Do you know, my children, what happened in history? When the Quran was revealed, the Arabs were the worst of the most backward people in the world. They were the most backward people. But when Allah Ta'ala told them, will you not use your aql? Will you not use your minds? Will you not ponder? So they started pondering. And if you see, after Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the 200-300 years, the period of 200-300 years, in that period we find the best scientists in the world were from the Arabs. Can you imagine? Somebody who's a failure and then he becomes a topper in the world. Suddenly this change came. And do you know what brought this change? The Quran, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the teachings of Islam, this brought the change. My question is, it brought the change that time. Can it bring the change now?
Yes.
Yes or no?
Yes.
It can bring the change again. We have the same Quran or different Quran?
Yes.
Same Prophet we are following or different Prophet?
Yes.
Same religion or different religion?
Yes.
Why we can't get it now? Why we can't get it now? We can get it now also. The best scientists in the world will be from the Muslims. The best developers, the best technology will be with us. But what happened, do you know? We left the Quran. We left Islam. Muslims generally. Little bit Islam was left. So they are very far. We became the most backward people in the world. Again. Because we have the blessing from Allah and we did not value it. The Quran is in every home, but people don't want to read it. They don't want to ponder. So they became the dullest people in the world. If you see the Sachar Committee report, it says Muslims are more illiterate, less educated, then even the most backward communities of India, the most backward are the Muslims in education. Why like this? When we leave Islam, Allah Rabbul Alameen punishes us. Because we have the blessing in our house and we don't want to benefit from it. We don't want to share it to others. But I have hope from Allah that the revival we see today throughout the world, youngsters, children, the new blood is coming to study Islam. They're coming to study the Quran. They're coming for knowledge. If the same trend continues, then that day is not far when we will see that technology advancement will come in the hands of the Muslims once again. It will come. But that will take time when we come back to the Quran and the Sunnah. When we come back to Islam, Allah's help will start coming for us. So my children, I want to tell you the second point. The second point is seek knowledge. For the sake of knowledge. You know why people seek knowledge? They say, I want to get knowledge to pass exams. Exams, so only one goal is there. Exams. Now a person is studying for exams. Anyhow, he will try to get good marks in the exam. Ask him the same question after 1 month. He said, I don't know. Because he did not seek knowledge for knowledge. We have to seek knowledge for knowledge. We are doing dua to Allah. Oh Allah, give me ilman nafiya, beneficial knowledge. What is knowledge? What is there with you? Is that knowledge you pass the exam after 1 month forgotten? Become a doctor, but just exams for the sake of exam. Became an engineer only for the sake of the exam. So my children, you don't do like this. Get knowledge for the sake of knowledge. Acha, tell me. If a student studies and gets knowledge for knowledge, then what difference will there be in this What difference will be there? Tell me. Such a child who gets knowledge for the sake of knowledge, there's this student. You know, distinguish between. On one side, we put such a student who is getting knowledge for the sake of knowledge. On the second side, we put a student who is getting knowledge for exams. What is the difference between the two? Who can tell? What difference we will see? Yes, Mahesh. He will be? No, even he passed in his exam. He was passed studying for exam.
But he will not be successful.
Yes. Well, finally, right now we are focusing on knowledge for the sake of knowledge, meaning we're talking of knowledge for the sake of learning. We're mainly talking about the dunya knowledge. And akhirah, of course, even that knowledge, some study. Some people get knowledge for the sake of getting the sanad degree. Huh? No. Some people say that seeking knowledge is for 5 years, 7 years. Seeking knowledge is until we are living. Until we live, we have to seek knowledge. The purpose of knowledge should not be just the certification. It should be for the sake of knowledge. Because Allah said that Allah taught us in the Quran, وَقُرْ رَبِّي زِدْنِي إِلْمَا. Say, oh my Lord, increase me in knowledge. Now I was telling, what difference will there be between these two? Come on, who can tell? Which two? First side we have one person who's getting knowledge for the sake of knowledge. And the second side we have someone who's doing for exams. Now what difference will there be? Yes. We put a name. This is Mr. A and that is Mr. B. Student A and student B. A is seeking knowledge for knowledge. B is getting knowledge for exams. Student A will get knowledge of everything. Okay, we try. Okay, someone else, a little bit more. This one will be really bright. He's not just mugging himself up. You see the results that now, okay, for exam time, both will know. But 2 months after exam, this will know and this one won't know. Huh? So which type you want to be? A or B?
A.
A. Yes. What other difference will be there?
A
will there be?
Spread the knowledge.
A can even spread the knowledge because he has real knowledge. B has namesake knowledge. B has something which will go away after exams. Because he's doing for exams, it will go away after exam. Yes.
Person who remembers his knowledge, he can use it for even benefit from it.
MashaAllah, very good, MashaAllah. Sometimes small children also speak such big words of wisdom, MashaAllah. Huh? I think you deserve a double big prize. Huh? Big prize for him. So you can benefit from it and you can teach it to others. Huh? Yes. What else? Difference will there be? What difference will there be? Now when that person goes back in society, so this person, Mr. A, who got knowledge for the sake of knowledge, now you tell him that balance sheet accounts, you have to make your company accounts, you have to balance the balance sheet, he can do it. Patient is there in front of you, he can do it. Building is there in front of you, he can do it. Because he is seeking knowledge for knowledge. So my children, exams you will succeed. That will happen. But don't make that the goal. The goal is knowledge for the sake of
knowledge.
Inshallah. There are so many people, they say, Mera to ek hi purpose hai. I want to pass in exams. Don't make yourself part of the crowd. Muslims are leaders. You know why? Allah says in the Quran, قَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ شَكُورٌ. From my slaves, there are very few grateful. And Allah says, وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Most people don't know. Most people don't know. Muslims know. So Muslims are people who are real believers, they are leaders in the world. They don't just follow the crowd. They lead the people to success. They take people, they take right steps. If you want to follow the crowd, you cannot be a true Muslim. If you want to be a true Muslim, you have to follow Allah and His Messenger. And that's what brings you forward in front of the people. So we have seen 2 points. First point was what? What was the first point?
The
purpose of? What are you doing this for? Jannah, to worship Allah Rabbil Alameen. Second, seeking knowledge for the sake of knowledge. Third point is use resources before they go away. Sensible thing is, use resources before it goes away. So now we have the hadith of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He said, اِغْتَنِمْ خَمْسًا قَبْلَ خَمْسٍ. Use 5 things, before 5 others come. 5 things, you use them properly before 5 others come. Hayataka kabla mautik. Use your life before your death. When we die, Can we do any good thing now? Can we do any good deed now? Can we say Astaghfirullah even once? Yes or no? Once? Once? Can we say even once?
No.
Now we can say?
Yes.
So use your life before we die. Number two, use your health. Sihataka qabla saqamik. Before you become sick. If you are sick, you can't do anything. Use your health before you become sick. وَشَبَابَكَ قَبْلَ حَرَمِكَ. Use your young age before you become old. Before you become
old.
See, you know, young people can learn things faster. So now learn the Quran, learn Islam, seek knowledge for the sake of knowledge. فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ. Everything now, use it. وَفَرَاغَكَ قَبْلَ شُغْلِكَ. Use your free time before you become busy. Free time before you become busy meaning? When we are free. So what do people do?
They play games. They do
time pass. See, some games are good for health. It's good, mashallah. But people waste things uselessly. It's very bad. And the last thing, your wealth. Malaka qabla faqrik. Your wealth before you become poor. Your wealth goes away. Use it. Use it to do good things before it goes away. So my children, use five before five others come. So I'll just give you an example. Igtanim. Igtanim means ganimat samjho. Matlab, use it in a good way. See, for example, you are on a journey and you have one bottle of water with you. Now how you'll use that water? How you will use it? Very carefully. You want to drink thora thora karke piyo, don't drink the whole thing in one shot. Will you use it for washing your face? Huh? Or the watering the plant?
No.
No, you use it properly now. You have only one bottle, use it. So my children, you know, so many people, they forget that when they are healthy, they forget they can fall sick. When they are young, they forget that they will become
old.
You know, people saying that main to old banne wala hi nahi hu. I'm not going to become old at all. You know, what do you call it? Old age proof. Huh? Nobody is old age proof. So like, for example, if you have little of something, you use it, na? So same way in the world, what were things we should use? Huh? What were things? Who can tell all five things, inshallah? Big prize for this. All five, who can tell? Yeah, yes, bacha, tell.
We should learn Quran.
No. Five things before five others come. Use five before five others come. Yes. Jazakallah. You can say.
Wealth before poverty.
Okay, no problem. Tell in any order. Wealth before poverty. Health before sickness, life before death, free time before you become busy, huh? And it's connected to you.
Young age before old age.
Young age before you become an old man, huh? So, five before five others come. Now see, mashallah, we see some people, they forget that they are going to become old one day. Huh? And you are going to have so many responsibilities. You know, young man, one day will come when inshallah you will have some young child in front of you who will say, Papa or Abba, huh?
Yes.
I want this thing. Now you have to carry him and you have to take care of your wife and you have to take care of your business. Now that time, how much you can achieve? Little bit. Huh? What little you can do, that time you will do. But now you can do everything, inshallah. You can learn lots of good things. You can learn the Quran, the best book in this world. The best book in this world. Quran is the book which was the master key for the progress of Muslims. It's the master key. If you can get this master key, you can get that progress, inshallah, if you become one who ponders on it, inshallah. Huh? So my children, you know what? I have seen so many examples. Musa alayhi salam, he used to stammer. But when he started speaking for Allah, people used to tremble. Bani Israel used to be afraid. When Musa alayhi salam was away, so they started worshipping the calf. Harun alayhi salam could not control. But Musa alayhi salam, Allah gave him that kind of thing. How did it happen? The powerful thing that came to him was Islam. That same powerful thing can come to us also, inshallah. So my children, use five before five others come. Now what happens? We see Some young man, as they say, khun mein garmi, huh? Jism mein taqat, body has strength, eyes are working properly, ears are working properly, mind is at the peak. And what is he doing? Computer games. Have you seen that thing, treasure? I'm sorry, yeah, you disconnected. You've seen though that thing, people, I, when you're sitting in the train sometimes or somewhere, so you see someone running and then running and getting the treasure. Huh? And how rich does he become at the end of the game? Nothing at all. See, if that would help you to go to Jannah, I'll say do it. But that is going to take us to Jannah. Huh?
No.
So point is what, you know, you're wasting your time. In the time in which you could have used that thing for good things, you're wasting it. Huh? So my children, be sensible. Don't be foolish. Huh? Use five before five others come. Now there's someone who's wasting time after cartoons. Entertainment. See my children, we know our purpose of life. We don't need entertainment. Why? Are we here for entertaining ourselves? Someone goes in the exam and for 3 hours he is enjoying himself. Bole, main exam mein to bahut aaram kiya. I really am feeling fresh after the exam. What do you think? Is it a good idea or bad idea? Why? Because you lost it. Now you will fail. That exam is not there for enjoyment. Exam is for exam. So this life is not for entertaining ourselves. There is time for entertainment, huh? There is a time which will come for entertaining yourself. Who can tell where? Huh? Akhira. Where in Akhira?
Jannah.
Jannah is a place where Allah says, Lahuma yasha'una fiha. They will get what they want. What do you want? What do you want? You like chocolates? Huh?
Yes.
What do you want? You want to fly in the air?
Yes.
There will be a farmer, he'll say, Allah, I want to do farming. So as soon as he puts the seed, he doesn't have to wait. Farmer has to wait, na? When the plant will come, and then he feels happy, the plant has come. So yeah, as soon as he puts the seed, immediately the plant will come out. They will get what they want. So the place for entertainment is there. But now this is the time for exam, my children. Don't waste it. Use five before five, others come. Okay, inshallah? So now what can be crossed out of your life? If you want to be a really bright student, number one, games, put them out.
Don't
healthy. Yes. Very good, mashallah. Who can tell some things we should not do? Let's see what we should not do. If you understood the rule, use five before five. Understood the rule, use five before five. Why am I showing this again and again? Why am I showing this? What's this doing over here? Five before five, this one. I give the example of water, na? This five also will go away. Like this water, now if you have only one bottle of water, you are going on a journey. So you will use it, na? You won't waste it. Similarly, these five we have limited. We cannot waste it, my children. Huh? Use five before five, others come. So now what we should not do? Come on. No prize for this. But if someone gives a very good answer, then maybe. Yes. What we should not do? No, not do meaning what? Under the rule, use five before five. What we should not do? Yes. What we should not do?
We should not waste our free time.
We should not waste our free time. Mashallah, we should read the Quran and...
Spread
knowledge and get knowledge, alhamdulillah. Very nice, mashallah. You get a prize for this. Huh? Yes. Who will that? You were raising your hand? I saw you raising your hand? No, someone from you, I saw someone raising the hand. Yes, I saw you raising your hand.
Same answer.
Same answer? Okay.
We should not waste our youth.
We should not waste our youth. How?
We should use it. We should take the best use of the age.
We can make the best use of our
age.
Huh? Best use. Okay. Tell me what bad use we should avoid and what good things we should do. Yes. What we should avoid, what we should do? Internet, mashallah, he's really told it. Today children are wasting time on internet and there are dangers that can take away the big blessing from them. Yes. You should use your health for what? For? Very good, mashallah. So now for example, someone is healthy and strong, he is offering salah, extra nafil salah, sunnatul muakkada and others. Now when he's sick, he's not able to do that. Huh? Do you know what reward he will get?
If you are healthy and you are praying, for example, you know the 12 rakats in the day, which if you read, what reward for that? This is for elders. If a person reads 12 rakats in one day, nawafil, from the nawafil, sunnatul muqadda, what reward will he get? Yes, from the elders, bhai. No bachas will come here now. Yes, tell, I can see. What reward? House in Jannah, mashallah. Booking is happening over here. Get your house in Jannah. Huh? Offer 12 rakats in the day other than the first salah. The two sunnat of Fajr, the four before Zuhar and two after Zuhar, two after Maghrib and two after Isha. 12. Okay. So my children, so now there's someone who's praying 12 when he's healthy. Now when he falls sick, he prays 0. How much reward will he get? When he was healthy, he was praying 12. When he's sick, he's praying 0. How much reward is in his account when he's sick? 0 or 12?
12.
How 12? He prayed how much? 0. Then how is he getting 12?
Because he used to pray.
He used to
pray 12, but now he is sick, so he can't pray.
When he was used to pray 12, when he was healthy, when he's sick, he's automatically getting it. But when he's sick, and that's when he says, I wish I could pray 12. Huh? No. If you are healthy and doing 12, or if you're doing 12 while you're in the city, and you're on a journey and you're doing 0, because you're on a journey, Fajr is only Qasr. Of course, Fajr to Sunnah, the Prophet ﷺ used to pray even in journey. So he's still getting the reward of 12 even in the journey. MashaAllah. Okay, my children, 3 points are over. First point was what? Purpose in life. Second point? Seeking knowledge for the sake of knowledge. Huh? Third is? Use 5 before 5. Use your resources before something goes away. Now point number 4. Now there may be someone who realizes all 3, but point number 4 will tell us of 8 things, 8 shackles. You know shackles, chain. Huh? Chain. Who's the strongest guy over here among the kids? Huh? I can see someone there. Mashallah. Yes, mashallah. What's your name, brother?
No, not you.
Okay. So there's someone who's very strong. Huh? Let's take someone who's very strong, but he's tied down by 8 chains. Now Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek Allah's refuge from these 8 things. It's a hadith recorded in Sahih Bukhari. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Allahumma inni a'udhu bika, O Allah, I seek your refuge min al-hammi wal-huzni, from worry and from grief." Worry? What is worry? Something worry is about something in the future or something of the past?
Future.
Or past?
Future.
Worry is about something of the
future.
So now a person is worried. Ah, exam is coming up. What's going to happen? Ah, he's really worried. So worried person cannot do anything. His worry is tying him down. There is a student who can do this much, but because he's just unnecessarily worried, he can't do anything. Huh? Okay? And huzn, grief. In Urdu we say gum, not the English gum. Huh? Now, grief is about the future or about the past?
Past.
Huh? Future or the past?
Past.
Past. About the past. Meaning what?
He's sad about what?
Sad about what? Give me an example.
What he didn't do right
in the past. He's not feeling sad. Now when you feel very sad, then you can't do. It's a chain which is tying you down. Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek Allah's refuge. Oh Allah, you save me from worry. You know, in worry, if a person is very worried, he can get heart attacks. He can get blood pressure. He can fall sick. Lots of things can happen to a person if he's worried. And when you are in grief, huh? Then what happens? Then also you can't be 100%. It's tying you down. It's a chain. Well, ajzi. Ajzi is what? Ajzi. Helplessness. Helplessness. For example, there's a boy. What's his name? Just give an example. Ahmad. Now we tell Ahmad, go and do this. Now Ahmad is going. In between there's a problem. And Ahmad says, no, I can't do. You give up, you fast. When you give up very easily, this is called helplessness. Have you seen ants walking on somewhere? Now if we put something in between, you put something in between, what will happen? There will be a big traffic jam over there. All the ants have collected because they don't know what to do. Huh? What will happen? They'll find some way. Huh? You know about the inky winky spider. Huh? Heard the story, na? Now Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to seek refuge from Allah from helplessness. My children, don't be that type of a person who just gives up. Ah, nahi ho raha hai. I can't do. Now it's because of this that person can't do. If you tell yourself, I can't do, you are making yourself weak. Don't say you can't do. Say, I can do. Because we do things with the help of
Allah.
313 was standing in front of 1,000. Who? Battle of Badr. And 313 were less equipped, less experienced, but they had who? Allah's help. My children, have you heard stories of big, big Sahaba? How Allah Ta'ala helped them? Huh? Have you heard the stories of how Allah's help came? You will see the story of one Sahabi who's standing in front of a king and he's talking without any hesitation. He's not afraid of the king. The king and I'm a normal man. No, he talks as if he's nothing. Allah Rabbul Alameen is Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest. My children, so don't have that helplessness in you. Don't give up. Don't defeat yourself. Exam is coming. Ah, I can't do. You can do, inshallah. When 313 can go and fight with 1,000. And do you know, in the battle of Muta, which was in 6 Hijri, there was a Muslim army of almost 6,000. If I'm not mistaken, was it 6,000 or 3,000? If I'm not mistaken, either 3,000 or 6,000. It fought with a Christian army of 1 lakh to 2 lakhs. Huh? And that was a battle in which the first commander of the Muslims was Zayd bin Haris. And he fought and he died, huh? Fighting. The second commander was Jafar bin Abi Talib. He fought and he died. The third commander was Abdullah bin Rawaha radhiyallahu anhu. He fought and he died. And before that, when they were saying, they had said, Abdullah bin Rawaha had said that we are not people who fight with men and numbers. We fight with the help of Allah. And the fourth commander was who? Big prize you'll get. Khalid bin Walid. And he fought, and he fought in such a way that later Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave him the prize, the title of Saifullah, the sword of Allah. So we are people who are following them. They are our aslaf. We are following them. We are following the Sahaba, the Tabi'in, the Tabi' Tabi'in. We are people behind, but we have role models before us. So don't be a person who gives up. Huh? And then fourth problem. First chain was what? Worry. Second chain? Grief. Third chain? Helplessness. Fourth chain? Walkasl. Being lazy. Being lazy. Now you know someone, he doesn't have the problem of worry. He doesn't have the problem of grief. He doesn't have the problem of helplessness. But he has a fourth problem. He's very lazy. So you know, you see some children, they are so lazy. Full day couch potatoes. Huh? Every time you see just lying them. This child is always lying around like this. Huh? You know what, my children, use your energy. Don't be lazy children. Huh? Don't be lazy, because that bright student is not lazy child. Well, bukhli. Bukhl is being what? Conjuice. Miser. You know miser? Miser meaning what? Miser means what? Yes? Huh? Greedy? Doesn't want to spend. Huh? So miser is, he doesn't want to, you know, the people, I have money, I'm not going to give it for anything. He's miser. But you know, miserliness is not only about money. There's someone who doesn't want to spend his energy. There's someone who doesn't want to spend his effort. He is miser in putting in his efforts. Huh? Wal ajzi, wal kasli, wal bukhli, wal jubn. Being coward. Being a coward. You know, some people are cowards. Cowards means what?
Scared.
Scared. Scared of what?
Scared of things.
Things like?
Exams.
Ah. So you know, some people, they can do some big things. For example, I'll tell you, you come here, you speak for Allah. Alhamdulillah, I was very happy to see that young boy who came here and read the Quran. So now there's someone who's coward. No, brothers, my children, no. We depend on Allah Ta'ala. Huh? We are believers in Allah Rabbul Alameen. So don't be a coward in your life, inshallah. Won't be. You know, there are cowards who are cowards who are, oh, cockroach! Oof. Running away from these, out. Cockroach has come, or rat, or lizard. Now what you will do when a lion will come? Huh? See, my children, these are small, small things. But further, if you see, there are things that people are cowards, that's why they don't do. Huh? There are so many people who want to do something innovative, something good, but they are really scared of everything. Ye ho jayega to kya ho jayega? I'll do this to kya ho jayega? I'll do that to kya ho jayega? Always scared, 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 can't do anything. So that is the chain which is tying them down. Wadal idaini wa ghalabati rijal. Coming under the burden of debt. Debt, you know what's debt?
Yeah.
You'll borrow money. Give me 10 rupees. Give me 20 rupees. Give me 100 rupees. Always borrowing, 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 borrowing. Okay. Until one day, there's so much borrowing that you can't do.
Return.
Return it. So under the burden of debt. See, if a person is under the burden of debt, now mind doesn't work. So people who have come under the burden, they know. And ghalabati rijal, someone comes and bosses you around. Ah, you're not going to sit here. You're not going to stand here. Well, if it's for good reason, we'll do it. If it's for good cause, we'll do it. But not because somebody wants to come and boss us around. Huh? So well, anyway, ghalabati rijal is people come and dominate over you and don't let you do good things. People who don't let us do good deeds. Huh? So my children, these are the 8 shackles. 8 chains which tie a person down. We've seen 4 points. First point was what?
Worry.
That was 8. 4 points we've seen. First point was what? Don't look in your notes for this. Look in your notes later, inshallah. First point is purpose in life. Second point is seeking knowledge for the sake of knowledge, inshallah. Number one, use resources before they go away. Use 5 before 5 others come. Huh? Number 4, the 8 chains which tie a person down. So now our student has, bright student has crossed these 4 stages. Let's look at the 5th. 5th is, my children, that what you do, we should have consistency. Consistency. You know what's that? What is the meaning of consistency? Yes?
Being good at...
good at something?
Regular.
And there's a hadith about this and there's a prize about that. Which hadith is there about this? Which hadith is there about this? Come on. There's a hadith about consistency. Okay, for the elders. One hadith about consistency. Yes. MashaAllah, there's a prize for the brother. Alhamdulillah. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ahabbul amali ilallah." The most beloved deed in the sight of Allah, ma duwima alayhi wa in qalla, is that in which there is consistency, there is regularity, dawam, hamechgi, even if it is small. Now tell me, who can tell, my children, pay attention, how does this hadith apply to children? The most beloved deed in the sight of Allah, the most beloved deed in the sight of Allah, is that in which there is regularity, consistency, even if it is small. Does this apply to children? It applies to children or no? How? How it applies to children? How? Don't talk about big people. Talk about children and your life. How does this hadith apply to you? Yes. Hard work ki baat hai ya consistency? Wain kalla, even if it is small. Small but regular. How does this apply? Yes. It doesn't apply to children. How? Salah regularly. In ibadah. Okay, mashallah, it does apply. Huh? Yes, yes, inshallah. Reading Quran. Okay, mashallah. So you'll get a small prize. I want a little bigger, better, more connected answer. How does it connect to a bright student? How does this rule apply to a bright student? Yes, my bacha, tell. Huh? By? Once again, little louder. Repeating good deeds, meaning what? Ha, mashallah, I think that goes along with that answer. Some other answer. Some other answer. You want me to pass this question to the elders? Elders will answer for children. Huh? Yes. Yes. How does this apply to the life of a child, a bright student?
For the big people.
Big people? No, no, no. Talk about kids. Okay. Sorry? Exam? Exam?
Example.
Example? You want to give an example? Yes, I want the example from you. I can give example, yes. But then I'll have to take the prize. Chocolate. Yes. Duas before sleeping, yes. I connected to what he has said. Something else? Okay, my elders, my brothers, can you answer the question for the children? How does this hadith apply to the life of a child? The most beloved deed in the sight of Allah, in which there is regularity, even if it is small. Yes. Yes, it comes that he has answered. Something else? The life of a child? Yes. Huh? Good to others, alhamdulillah. That comes in that. Sorry? MashaAllah. You know, some children, exam time, books are till here. You have to see where is he. They are behind the books, he is somewhere. But exam ke baad? No books. Only exam time, some people say also. I study only during exam time. So this is very good answer, mashallah, prize for this brother. So the most beloved deed before Allah is that in which there is regularity, even if it is small. Huh? Acha, tell me, someone wants to become a very powerful. You know the hadith? He wants to become strong. The hadith that Al-Mu'minul Qawi Khairun wa Habrilallahi min Mu'minul Da'if. The person, the strong believer, is better than a weak believer. Huh? Wafi kullin khair. But in both there is good. So now, you know, being strong. So now someone wants to be strong. He says, I read the hadith. Now morning he goes in the gym and full day he's exercising and he comes out in the night. So what, he'll be having muscles bulging from everywhere? Huh? If by the evening? What will we tell him? Let's see, you be regular. Huh? So my children, you know what happens? Knowledge for the sake of knowledge. Avoid the 8 things. But it's also important that we should be regular in what you do. You must have seen waterfalls on a stone. One drop. What happens after some time? After 1 year, what happens? After 6 months, what happens? The stone has developed a hole. That drop of water did it. This is how it happens. This is how Allah has made things. So what you do now, don't be moody. One day so much, second day gayab. Huh? One day so much and then not doing anything at all. So do more also sometimes, no problem, but have a regular level. Huh? Regular level. In ibadah also, like the brother rightly said, and also in worldly matters. So we've learned 5 things for today now. Now my time has run out. Huh? What should I do? Just briefly mention the other 2, inshallah. Point number 6. Now someone is doing all these things. But how is he with his creator? He knows his purpose in life. See, a bright student has to offer salah. If you want to be a bright student, you have to offer salah. You know what, my children? Salah gives us sukoon. You get peace of mind. You learn to concentrate. If a person learns to pray salah properly, he learns to concentrate in anything. And when he learns to concentrate, it can help him in his work. It can help him in his life. It can help him in his studies. So learn to offer salah, my children. And you know what our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about this? He said, and it's something so important. So you know what? A child comes, he says, I want to play with the fire. So what will the parents say? No, no, no. And if he doesn't understand, then they have to make him understand. Because it's better for him not to play with fire. If you burn, then you can cause damage to yourself. So you know the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, hadith recorded in Sunan Abu Dawud, he said, Muru awladakum bis salah wa hum abna'u sabin. Command your children to offer salah when they are 7 years old. When they are 7 years old, tell them that you offer salah. Come on now, you have to offer salah. Before that, you can teach. Before that, you can encourage. But commanding is at 7 years. Wadribuhum alayha wa hum abna'u ashrin. Are you listening? If they become 10 years old and they still don't offer salah, then beat them. Beat them means the Prophet ﷺ prohibited anyone for beating on the face. We are not allowed to beat on the face. But the purpose of beating them is so that they understand how important it is. See, you know what, my children? It's important that we realize how good is this. I tell you, you're there with me today. And I think, mashallah, I can see that everyone is above seven, all of this group over here. There are some very small kids, I understand. But most of you are above 7 years. And someone has crossed 10. Now you do your own rationing. Offer salah regularly. See, my children, when you offer salah, you get that big blessing from Allah because the best deed is salah. Huh? The Prophet said, Ahabul amali ilallah. The Prophet said, the best deed among inna min khiyarikum. The best of your deeds is salah. Salah is the best deed. So my children, make it a point to offer salah. Now what? Offer salah regularly, consistently. Offer salah with your heart in it. Huh? Learn the meaning of what you're offering in salah. Okay, now I have a question. Who can tell me the meaning of Sami Allahu liman hamida? Who can tell? 1 minute. One hand? Two. Who has not got any prize still will answer? Who has not got any prize? You will answer? Yes, tell. What is the meaning of Sami Allahu liman hamida? Everywhere glory to Allah won't fit. Jazakallah khair for trying, but. Chalo, who can tell? What is the meaning of Sami Allahu liman hamida? Yes? Allah listens to those who? Half prize you'll get. Give half prize here, mashallah. Yes. Hamida. Those who praise Him. Allah listens to those who praise Him. And then what do we say? What do we say? Rabbana wa lakal hamd. And what is the meaning of Rabbana wa lakal hamd? Or Rabbana lakal hamd. Both are authentic. What is the meaning of this? All praises for Allah. You will get the prize. Full price, inshallah. You will get half the price for trying. Huh? I don't know how they'll give half, but that I'll leave it to them. Okay, the point is that my children, the point is that what you're offering in salah, don't you think we should know the meaning of what we say? Huh? Someone comes and tells you blah 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 something and he doesn't know what he's saying. Huh? Will you like it? We stand before Allah and we don't know what we are saying. Don't you think we should know? What do you think? Shouldn't we know what we are saying or not? Okay, my children. So get your connection with Allah. Good. And that is by offering salah regularly. 5 times a day. Not because somebody is watching. But because who's watching? Allah is watching. Allah is watching or not? Even small children, Allah is watching. Even small children, Allah is watching. Answer me. Small children also, Allah is watching. Are you sure? Yes. And last point, point number 7, is now there's someone who's doing all 6 things, but a bright student who doesn't realize the importance of his akhlaq, his character, he is not really bright in the world. Do you know, in the world when you go out tomorrow, you see there are people who are genius, but they don't know how to behave with people, who are arrogant, who are proud, who don't care. So my children, I encourage all of you that we should develop good akhlaq. And who is the example for us? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, he said, innal mu'mina, indeed the believer reaches the darajat as-sa'im al-qa'im, the level of the person who offers salah full day, meaning the salah in the qiyam al-layl it's talking about. Sa'im, the person who offers, who fasts. You meet him, can't even fasting. Why fasting? Because Monday and Thursday, 13, 14, 15. And there's a person who's, everybody's sleeping in the night and he's offering salah. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ الْمُؤْمِنَ لَيُدْرَكُ بِحُسْنِ قُلُقِهِ دَرَجَةَ السَّائِمِ الْقَائِمِ. He reaches by his good akhlaq the level of a saim and qaim. A person who's fasting and who's offering salah. So my children, good akhlaq is very important. Huh? By your good akhlaq, you can get so many good deeds. Huh? The Prophet said, there's nothing, ma min shayin athqalu fil mizan min husnil khuluq. There is nothing which is more heavier in the mizan. Mizan? Mizan? Scale. Min husnil khuluq. Than good akhlaq. The best and the heaviest thing. You know the heavy, the weights, na? Okay, this is 100 grams. This is 1 kilo. This is 100 kilo. So the heaviest thing in the mizan, the Prophet ﷺ said, is husnul khuluq, is the good akhlaq. And part of good akhlaq in Islam is how we are with Allah, Tawheed, how we are with the Prophet, Ittiba, how we are with people. So it's all part of good akhlaq. So my children, these are 7 points for all of you. And before I finish, I want to tell you that this life is finally a test. You can be someone who is bright for the dunya and bright for the akhirah. Second option, someone who is bright for the dunya but dull for the akhirah. Or you can be someone who is dull for the dunya and dull for the akhirah. Because when you do for akhirah, you get dunya in bonus. That is why there is no such thing like bright for the akhirah and dull for the dunya. That option is not there. So now there are three options. First is bright for the dunya and bright for the akhirah. Second is bright for the dunya but dull for the akhirah. And third is dull for the dunya and dull for the akhirah. Now which of these three you want to choose for yourself? First option. I invite all of my children that please pay attention to this. This is the chance that we have. And as Muslim children, alhamdulillah, children who are getting to listen to all of this from the Quran and the Sunnah, it's favor from Allah. This is favor from Allah because so many people, they have to grow up and they seek the truth and then they come to the truth. So they lost this chance which you are getting. The chance which you are getting to study the Quran, study the hadith and act on it, inshallah. So the Prophet ﷺ said, and I end with this hadith, he said, Sabatun yuzilluhum Allah ta'ala fi zillihi yawma la zilla illa zilla. The Prophet ﷺ said, seven are those who will be in the shade of Allah's throne on the day when there will be no shade other than the shade of Allah's throne. And the first one, the Prophet ﷺ said, Shabun Imamun Adlun, the good leader, who's just leader. And the second he said, Shabun Nashafi Ibadatillah. Shabun, the young man who grew up in the ibadah of Allah. What is your age? What's your age? 10 years? What's your age? Huh? 10? What's your age? 14? Shabun Nashafi Ibadatillah. The young man whose age increased in the ibadah from Allah. In the ibadah of Allah, what's your name, bacha? Huh? Rayyan. Zayyan. So Zayyan is 10 now. Nashafi ibadatillah means what? From 10 he became 12 in the ibadah of Allah. From 12 he became 15 in the ibadah of Allah. 15, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. Whatever Allah gives in the ibadah of Allah. And there are those people who plan. They say, ah, no, what we'll do, you know now? We'll enjoy ourselves. And when we become old, before dying, we will start doing ibadah. Some people have this planning. They say, abhi to enjoy karo, baad mein marne se pehle ibadat karna shuru kar denge. So if you see in Hajj, you know, Hajj, most of the people from India, you will find old people there. You know why young people don't come for Hajj normally? If someone is going for Hajj, it's amazing. But old people they go for, they say, hamara abhi to Allah Allah karne ka time aa gaya. You know, Allah Allah karne ka time aa gaya means what? Now it's come time for us to remember Allah. So what do you think, which planning is good? How is this planning that when you become old, then you start doing ibadah? How is this a plan? What do you think about this plan?
From the age of 7.
Why? But because before dying, you become good deed. You start doing good deeds. Why to do from now? From 10, Zayyan will do 10, 20, 30. MashaAllah, give him a prize. Huh? We don't know when death will come. Can you give me guarantee that you will become 60? Can Zayyan give guarantee? Can anyone give guarantee? No. Second point, tell. Huh? Yes. Yes. By the time if a person is saying 50 years, then I'll start doing good deed. 50 years of bad deeds are there behind him. Second point. MashaAllah. Third point. Yes. Huh? You don't get the shade of Allah's throne. You will become old and then start doing ibadah, then that shade of Allah's throne is for those who do shabun nashafi ibadatillah, who grow up in the ibadah of Allah. Then what else? Tell me fast. Very important point is missing. Should I give it to elders?
Yes. You can do it easily when we are young.
You can do it easily when you are young. MashaAllah, he'll also get. But I want the best part still coming. Yes?
We learn how to correct knowledge.
Yes, we learn how to correct knowledge. MashaAllah. The prizes are running out? Okay. Yes. The children are giving so many answers that prizes have to run out. Na? If there were dull students, I can't help it. Yes.
It will be hard for us when we become
regular.
You heard that? You heard it? Kya baat boli hai, mashallah, is bache ne. Give him double prize. This one. What's your name, Bacha? Give him also. Okay. Abdul Fatah. Huh? Abdul Fatah. He heard what he said? Say that again. Can you come here and say it? Kya baat boli hai? I feel like sitting down and listening to you. Come here. Come here fast and tell everyone. Just repeat what you said. Yes.
It will be hard for us when we become old.
Meaning what? Explain.
Means if we become old, we will not be able to pray easily.
He starts doing it from young age, it becomes easy. Huh? Old age mein jaake karna easy ho jata hai. Old age mein jaakar start karne jayenge, to then it becomes. Jaise gaadi hai jo chal rahi hai, chalti bhi gaadi chalti rahe acha hai. Old age mein jab creaky old ho gayi hai, rusty old machine ko start karna, it becomes difficult. But there's one more very important point. Who can tell?
Regularity.
What else? Okay, now for the elders. Ye plan kaisa hai? What do you think? Abhi bad deeds karna young age mein, enjoy karo, baad mein old hoke marne se pehle ibadat karna shuru kar denge. Kaisa plan hai? Huh? Who can tell what is wrong in this plan? Jo ye logon ne bataya wo repeat nahi karna. Yes. Elders are saying, bachcho ko hi karne do. Let us sit and watch today. Yes.
When we are young,
huh?
So we do bad things and we continue on.
Yes, it continues, yes.
If you go from the smallest, the Allah will be increased.
Yes, that has been said. Yes.
If you do from smallest, you will learn and when you
come. See, I'll explain. You know, when a person does bad deeds, na? He gets a kanat nuktatun saudau fi qalbi. A black dot comes on his heart. And if you don't do tawbah, it stays. You do more sins, more black dot, black dot, black dot, black dot, black dot, until finally full heart becomes black. Then there is a stage, there is rust. Kalla bal ran ala qulubihim. There is rust on the heart. Then the heart becomes hard. And then finally a stage comes, when a heart is locked, and finally a stage comes, when there is seal on the heart. Khatam Allahu ala qulubihim. Now someone is doing bad, isn't he afraid? Okay, there may be a seal on his heart, and so many people, when they become old also, they don't feel like doing good deeds. Because now a seal has come on their heart. Huh? So this is a very bad plan, my children, you don't do like this. And inshallah, we want to be from the seven who are under the shade of the throne. The day there is no shade other than the shade from Allah's throne. Inshallah, you will grow up in the ibadah of Allah. Inshallah. We grow up in the ibadah of Allah. Inshallah. Live in the sake of Allah. Live on Islam and die on Islam. Ameen. Wa akhir da'wan. Alhamdulillah. Rabbil alamin. Okay. There are any questions on the subject? So we can tell. See, I have two questions over here. We have the first question, is that children will get the first priority. Today's program is for children. Huh? So elders get lots of chances. So though there are two questions over here, but I think I want to take questions from the children first. Yes, any child has any questions about the 7 points? Okay, who can tell all 7 points, inshallah? All seven you'll tell, inshallah? Without looking in your book? Huh? Okay, sir, tell.
Purpose of life.
Seek knowledge.
Use resources before
they go away. You can see a little bit gone. Huh?
Eight chains
which tie a person. Yes.
To be consistent on good things.
Huh? On good things. Don't be moody. Huh? Then.
To offer salah
regularly, inshallah.
Huh? Develop good akhlaq.
And last point, how we conclude it? The appeal is to become from whom?
From
followers of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Yes, but who? Yes. Seven under the shade of the throne. From one of them is? One of them.
is the one who grows up in the ibadah of Allah. So Zayyan inshallah, from 10 becomes 20, 30, 40, 50 in the ibadah of Allah inshallah. Yes, it's an example. Any one of us I'm talking about. Yes. Jazakallah. Any questions now? Fast, fast. We have very limited time. Huh? Okay, I'll take the two questions. The first question is, what is the time of Sunnatul Muakkada? What is the time meaning? Of course, it has different times. So the 12 rakats we saw about was the 2 rakats before Fajr, 4 rakats before Zuhur, 2 rakats after Zuhur, 2 rakats after Maghrib and 2 rakats after Isha. That makes it 12. But there are others, like for example, the Prophet ﷺ said, may Allah have mercy on the person who prays Arba, 4, before Asr. Then there's a hadith which talks about the Prophet ﷺ said, he said, Sallu qabla al-Maghrib, Sallu qabla al-Maghrib, Sallu qabla al-Maghrib. Offer salah before Maghrib, offer salah before Maghrib, offer salah before Maghrib. Liman Shah, who wants to. Meaning it's not compulsory, it's not from the Muakkada also. So before Maghrib, farz, 3 farz, there's 2 rakats. Then he said, between every azan and iqama, there is time for salah. Huh? Between azan and iqama, you can offer salah. And then the Prophet ﷺ said that none of you should sit in the masjid before لَا يَجْلِسَنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ حَتَّى أَن يُسَلِّيَ رَكَاتَيْنِ. Don't sit in the masjid until you offer 2 rakats. And there are the 2 rakats of istikhara. And there are the rakat with the Prophet ﷺ used to pray إِذَا حَزَبَهُ أَمْرٌ صَلَّى. When something would worry him, he would offer salah. So there are lots of salahs of those kind. Further, second question. Keep wearing the garments above the ankle. Yes, we find so many children who are not cautious about this. You know what? They say fashion. So they want to follow the fashion of the film stars. The film stars, huh? So they follow the fashion of the film stars. But my children, you know what is the fashion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Huh? His garment used to be above the ankle. Above the ankle. And he said that, it's recorded, hadith is recorded in Sahih Bukhari, book of libas, book of dress. He said that Masfala min al-izari min al-kaban fahuwa finnar. The portion of the izar which is below the ankle is in the fire of hell. So now I can't tell the small children that you grow a beard. Huh? Grow a beard. Now how you'll get a beard? But one thing you can do now is you can show that you are the follower of not the fashion of the film stars, you are the follower of the fashion of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by keeping your pants above the ankle, inshallah. Huh? And you keep intention of the beard also, inshallah. Huh? Our time is up. So, inshallah, we have some messages from the Quran and the Sunnah, my children. And I invite all of you that you ponder about this, inshallah, and act on it. We do dua to Allah. May Allah make this program a source of goodness for our dunya and akhirah. And may Allah help all our children and all our people to become bright for the dunya and for the akhirah. Ameen wa akhir da'wan and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah.
Assalamu alaikum. Indeed, what a beautiful way to bring down the curtain for his last 1 month's lectures. And he's been with us for the last 1 month, and may Allah reward him, Jazakallah khairan, for his such a beautiful lecture. Even in fact today's, it was such a wonderful lecture that students, even till it's 2:30, past 2:30, they're still very energetic, Such an interactive session it was. And I'm sure it's going to have an positive impact on the students. And as well as, it will be a very helpful for the parents as well to upbring their children. And I would like to ask our president to hand over a bouquet, gift of momentum to Sheikh Zayed Patel. Jazakallah khair. So I would like to thank all those gathered over here, and especially for Zayed Patel. You have been such a wonderful inspiration throughout all this last 1 month, and those lectures, those workshops that you have conducted, definitely gonna help us in this, especially in our dawah efforts. And this lecture, this particular lecture, you students, you are the future generation, and with you, you are the torchbearers of Islam. And I'm sure one of you will be like Zaid Patel one other day, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.